need him for our discussion, but I thought we'll just wait.
Probably the other half of that.
And I got to finish this.
He was hungry. He went to the fire department at six.
How was that jalapeno sauce? We had to go get water.
Just maybe yours.
Oh, that's mine, thank you.
Okay, we're back. Excuse my.
So I just, my thought is just kind of, is I think if everybody kind of has a top two, that might be able to go through and just hear who your top two are or were. And then maybe that at least give you everybody's in general consensus on those candidates that might help with the discussion a little bit as well. So.
In ranked order?
No, it's just who your top, not the top two.
Yeah, I had already said Tom, Monica, and Alan.
Mine is Tom. It's close, but it's funny.
So you want down one or just gonna?
Tom, well, I can, Tom goes beyond.
Oh, okay.
My second one.
All right. And I basically have the same two, I think, for a lot of reasons.
Alan's Tom.
Okay. So those are the two that you, I mean, that you have, so you want to talk about the, your thoughts on both of them? Maybe, you know, perspective is, you know, what, you know, look at the questions and, you know, what you feel maybe they bring to the table and based on what you feel that you're looking for in this person.
I guess for me, again, it's, I think Tom brings a little different perspective to it because of his age. I mean, he's got young kids.
How old are you?
He's got young kids. You know, they're in Cub Scouts, so.
He's got a seventh grader, Ruby, and then Jack is at college.
And to me, that's important as we move ahead with a lot of different things is that I think they do he can offer something, a different perspective than somebody who has older kids and who are out of school. Just to give your mind, and that's what I like about Scott. And Scott brought a different perspective to the table, more so than what we bring. More tech savvy, more, you know, more in tune with Facebook and what's going on. And I think that is a positive thing for us as a council to have a perspective.
I like his name.
Talks very smooth and very calmly. You can tell he's acted. And, you know, I mean, he's comfortable in speaking. And the one comment I'll make about Alan in comparison, he seemed really nervous tonight. And I think it's because he wanted it so bad, but he's not normally that nervous and flighty. So I was really surprised to see that because he's always very controlled until he gets, you know, but so that was one difference. I guess I look at Alan and I think, boy, he could hit the road running because he seems to be more knowledgeable about some of the things that are going on within the city. I know he's followed them for the 10 years that he's been on the EAC. I look at Tom, I like that kid. And I shouldn't call him a kid. But I see Tom as being someone, whether he were to get on now or not, would continue to run. Or if he didn't get on now, he still would at some point in the future run. But I felt real sincerity out of both Alan and Tom. But I think Alan's maybe just got a little more under his belt to to be able to get up to speed faster.
I always try to focus on a couple of questions, even though I thought we had several good questions. And, one of the things that I usually use, and it's usually always a question, and, you know, which I like in managers' interviews and others, is strengths and weaknesses always tend to be an area. I know when it came to Tom's answer, you know, I kind of, you know, noted it. I mean, with about, you know, consensus and harmony and responsiveness, and, you know, and the fact that and his weakness, he said, you know, he likes to move on. And I think that that's, I think, something that that we strive for. I know Terry has that kind of background too, is moving, you know, let's get something, let's get things done. But what I thought was a good response with that was, he also said, I know we can't forget about what we've done and what it means, and we need to sustain, is what he used the term. And I thought that was, you know, really, to me, kind of a, you know, an answer that I liked. I mean, with the idea particularly of a consensus and harmony. And not that we have to, again, be all in agreement, but I think it's important that we try to do what we can to build consensus.
And I like the first one. I liked his pride thing. He loves living here. I just liked his, you know, for not knowing a whole, he's aware of what's going on. I mean, I was pretty impressed with that, for not being in a lot of stuff. I think he's got a lot of passion for the city.
It was interesting. By both of them, what I thought was a strength was they both had even a background. And I don't think Tom said it, but I noticed in his resume, it was on a corporate level, but in strategic plans and strategic planning development. Because I think that's really any city, but a city that our size with a lot of needs, you know, it's important we keep our focuses. And I thought it was nice of both of them to compliment the strategic plan and say it was, you know, readable and, you know, made sense. You know, I thought they both had taken appeared at least a substantial look on it.
I think they're both very strong candidates.
Younger thought.
I like the younger perspective. What it brings to the council.
So I guess the question is if you frame it in your mind in terms of what you think the person should bring, what you expect, what you want out of that candidate, so just in your own thought process, what are those qualities that you have and who fits all of those, the majority of those? You've heard from all four of them, and you've got two. So, you know, so what are the, you know, two things that you look to, you know? And I guess in many respects, when I'm hiring somebody, I have two questions. You know, I ask the question, first question is, what are the duties of the job? And second question is, who's a transformational leader that can help push the envelope and move us forward and those sorts of things. So, you know, those are questions I ask. Those are qualities that I have.
I think they both offer.
Alan maybe a little more, but maybe just because he's got a few more years experience. But
mature. Yeah.
I mean, the idea that he's worked with so many different cities, strategic plans and all of that, I think Tom's again, you know, can get there, but that would be my thought on it. That Alan's had more experience with him.
But, you know, one of the things that kind of hits me with this too, and again, we did have that with Scott too. I mean, no offense to any of us, but none of us are spring chickens anymore. Oh, Terry's still, Candy's still.
No, not really.
But I mean, it's kind of like, you know, how do we kind of get that next generation kind of leadership kind of brought in. I mean, that kind of drives me a little bit too on that. I mean, Alan has certainly a lot of skill level and experience, second to none. Even has beaten me already, and he's still working 40 years. And he has that. But I think of, you know, how do we get engaged with, you know, and just the types of things that Tom, and it was interesting because, you know, it sounded like Jason when he started referring to like e-commerce and stuff. I mean, things that I know of but have no clue of. And I think that's a perspective that's good to have. And then we saw that again with Scott too, how they would bring that and remind us that that's something that's how we are going to reach the next generations of young people, and probably anybody under 30 already or under even 40 in the community is that e-commerce approach of, and you know, it doesn't even enter my mind until somebody else brings that up in discussions of anything. But now at least we have it in the strategic plan, and that helps keep that into focus as well. So I think that's another thing the younger set kind of brings a little bit. Any thoughts? I mean, what should we do? Should we? I mean, do we want to vote? Do we want to?
Takes a motion in a second.
Man, you know, I don't know what we talk some more.
Well, I'm leaning toward Tom. That's my decision. I mean, that's what I.
I don't know if Jan's there.
No, I gotta be honest. I think Alan could get into position quicker. So. And I think at this point that's kind of all we need. And I look at Tom and I go, well, but this kid could run at the next election. But I think that Alan would get up to speed a lot quicker. But that's my feeling on it. He's just got so much background that is a gift to bring to the table.
Maybe both bring.
They do, yeah. You know, yes. Somewhat different, but
there's strengths. You know, Alan's got strengths in, you know, areas, and Tom's got strengths.
And Tom does too.
You know,
said I mentioned some of my personal things, and the caddy said it too. He really kind of, for some reason, he presented that kind of that community pride thing. Just, I don't know, like I said, I really appreciate his sincerity.
That was the first thing
sincerity.
Out of his mouth, and he was sincere about it.
Yeah.
And then, what happens? He's a lifelong resident.
A couple of organizations where I was younger now, you know, he's had, you know, the older people that were part of the, that's not so much because of business association and stuff. And it was hard for them to let me, you know, as a younger person, to get in. And once I did, it's like, you know, they were very appreciative. Yeah. And that's what I see in this, you know, I just see that there is someone there that has the potential. And I think, have a lot of assets in him. And they both would. I think they both would. Just like the idea of someone with that age level.
Mm-hmm. Jason, can you mention just some of your thoughts on how you call it, but you know, you use a different term, but a briefing of bringing someone along. Up to speed. Do you have some vision on that?
So, if you made your decision tonight, I would make arrangements with the person that you select to come in to sit down with me. Obviously, one, I would issue them their iPad, and as I've told all the candidates, there's a budget meeting on Tuesday night. Mm-hmm. Even though you're appointed, technically, you don't have any kind of authority as a council person until you're officially sworn into office, but they would have the ability of being involved and participate in discussion. I think I you know, I've heard in our previous work session on the 19th where we talked about this, that was kind of an expectation, and you wanted to get them involved as soon as possible. So on the onboarding sort of thing would be just a one, schedule a time for them to come in, just kind of talk a little bit about, you know, North St. Paul, you know, kind of get them a little more acquainted in the structure of the, you know, government, how plan B, how that works. Then also talk, give you an opportunity to introduce them to the staff, you know, any of the directors, get them acquainted with those operations, issues and things that are going on there, talk about, walk through the budget, talk about the strategic plan, all the different things, kind of some of the stuff that we've been working on, directions that council's given, those sorts of things, so that they're, have at least a, regardless of who it is, have a better understanding of everything that's kind of going on at this particular moment in time, and even some of the things that we're looking at into the future, so they have kind of an idea of, they have some playing field of which they're coming in with.
Try to do that in the, with before the swearing in council.
Yep. So we plan to do that something like next week. Yeah, so it'd be kind of a, you know, crash course in some aspects of what's going on, but you know, there's enough information out there too that they have the ability of bringing back on, whether it's council minutes or other sorts of things, to really kind of get some of the behind the scenes. But you know, there's a lot of different things that are going on, and here's some of the things that we're working on, here's, and you try to keep it, you know, here's what the issue is, here's some of the things that we're looking at, here's some of the discussion that the council's had to this date, or some of the stuff that staff is working on that's coming to council, so they're at least, you know, kind of whenever the person does officially be sworn into the office, in office on the 16th, that that's where we're at and heading, and then at least they're, you know, have as much understanding of where things are at, and obviously then they'll be able to provide their thought and guidance in terms of where things are going at that point. And wanting to include them, for you, wanting to include them in on the budget discussion on Tuesday's report, because they're in, then they're in on the ground running at that point as well.
Well, that's one area that I think Alan's got more experience, is the budget, is the number stuff from his resume.
Yeah. Well, he indicated that too. But I think, you know, as I look at them, I mean, they both are, I think, you know, very intelligent. I mean, they both you know, seem to have a record of, they come from different aspects. I mean, where Alan's more, not completely, but more private, public sector, not more private sector. But I think they're both will be, you know, pick up on things quickly, because, I mean, they're smart people. You can tell just how they present themselves. So, if we're comfortable, I know we don't have a apparent consensus, we can take action this evening, and I think that that would be our reasonable intention to do that, just because of the timeline for the next meeting and briefings. So, it would be a motion.
Yep, this is a meeting, so you're able to take action. And again, I'll just say you're not under no obligation to do that, but I mean, just if you so choose, that's your decision to do that this evening.
So can we ask you what were your thoughts?
Nope.
Oh, we can't.
Well, it's not, I mean, it's your decision, it's not up to me. I mean, I took notes and jotted things down, and I mean, some of it was just what things I might need to be able to work with them on to get them up to speed on different things. And so I kind of learn of who they are as well. So whoever person that you ultimately selected, regardless of the four of them, you know, I know what areas I can work with them on and things that I have a better understanding of who they are as well. So
you'll tell us after we vote.
Nope.
I'll make a motion to appoint Tom.
Seconded. So the motion is seconded. Discussion. Hearing no discussion, all those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed?
I go for hell.
Okay, yeah, I understand that. He's a good guy. I learned so much from him.
Tom's going to be a great guy, too. Yeah.
I think we had just two really good solid choices.
And isn't that nice?
We all agree.
Yes.
We all agree.
I mean, we've had times when we've had.
Yeah, exactly. It's never easy to make a decision when you had a couple, you know, some good candidates. It's hard.
I enjoyed all four of them.
Oh, yeah. It was a very, very positive. I thought I was going to enjoy it as much as I could.
So I'll ask this question then. So you selected Tom. Do you want me to call him or do you want Mayor to call him?
I mean, it doesn't matter to me.
Probably the mayor.
The mayor, probably.
Okay. Makes sense. So you call him first and I'll follow up with him.
Yeah, I call him right now.
Yeah.
There he is.
Is he home yet?
No. He's home.
He's at everyone. Well, you never know.
And then you got to call the other people or not?
Well,
we should.
Yeah,
yeah,
I'll let,
you
we'll let
them know.
Yeah.
So does anybody have anything else related to the subject matter? If not, like we have a motion in order to adjourn the special meeting of June 3rd. Is that moved by Councilmember Peterson? Seconded by Councilmember Furlong. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, we stand adjourned.
You want these guys?
Yep, I'll take those back.